20th of November 2007, and here we are at the top of the world's highest wind turbine at the Veladero gold mine in Argentina in the middle of the Andes. This morning, Marek finished erecting this wind turbine, and at 4,100 meters above sea level and 4,160 meters here, this is the highest wind turbine in the world.
Lo que primero sentí fue orgullo el desafío.
Entre las empresas mineras, somos una de las que está a la vanguardia, que ha apostado por las energías renovables y que no solamente hemos apostado en teoría, sino lo estamos materializando.
I've been working as a civil engineer for 10 years and I must say that this is one of the biggest challenges that I've ever had.
It's been a challenging project from day one. It's been a really, truly international effort with people involved from South America, North America, people from Europe as well. That includes contractors and vendors and equipment manufacturers from all over the world.
There is no one answer to the energy problems that we have. And since we've started this project, Barrick were the first mining company to talk to us about supplying their mine with wind energy, with a renewable energy source.
Barrick is obviously interested in evaluating and examining and testing alternative sources of energy.
Era un desafío especial porque estábamos creando algo que era nuevo, algo que no existía.
Va a ser un proyecto único en el mundo, la unidad de generación de electricidad eólica más alta del mundo.
We're very pleased that Barrick asked us because we think that we're an innovative company, because Barrick, I believe, asked other people and they said that there was not such an easy place to put a wind turbine.
Aquí estamos hablando de incorporar en un lugar que se podría decir que es inhóspito, un aerogenerador, un molino de viento de considerable tamaño, de última generación, y ubicarlo en ese lugar para hacer ese pequeño aporte al cuidado del medio ambiente, a una actitud responsable.
La alternativa de la generación eólica es una fuente renovable de energía, la búsqueda de una energía sustentable en el tiempo que esté de acorde con los altos respetos que la compañía tiene para el medio ambiente.
This is a prototype wind turbine, and it will be specially designed to work at altitude at 4,100 meters, which is over 2,000 meters higher than the highest wind turbine presently at the moment, which is, I believe, in the Alps, which is around about 2,000 meters.
Ese equipo es único en el mundo. El primer equipo se instaló en Cuxhaven, en Alemania, para probar y comprobar que la idea, la verdad, va a funcionar.
It's a 2 megawatt wind turbine, 2,000 kilowatts. So the wind turbine will, we're hoping when it's running at its peak capacity, when the wind's blowing the strongest, it will provide between 15 and maybe 20% of the actual whole mine consumption. This project started in 2005, September 2005. Barrick took the very innovative decision to explore the possibilities of having some renewable energy at their mine. And everybody thought that this place was a really windy place. So they came across Seawind, based in the UK. And we came here and measured the wind. We looked at several different sites at this mine. We found that this was the most convenient site.
So we started out with a measurement campaign of 1 year to find out what exactly the environmental conditions were and to assess which parameters would be critical in terms of the design of the wind turbine.
With the great wind resource that we measured here, we realized that it was definitely a good idea to bring a wind turbine of this size to their site. we started the process of searching the world for wind turbine manufacturers. Not all wind turbine manufacturers were interested to supply a wind turbine for this location because it's such a remote area and it's very difficult to get here. We found a company based in Germany called DeWin, who were interested to help us to develop a wind turbine specifically for this project.
And we found that especially the air density at this site, 4,000 meters or more than 4,000 meters, was going to present some problems, especially in terms of the electrical systems.
Many of the components of this wind turbine were re-engineered and changed because, for example, at a higher altitude, the air is much thinner and some of the electrical components don't cool in the same way. So we had to make some of the components larger than they needed to be so that they would cool more effectively.
Este proyecto ha tenido una serie de desafíos tecnológicos importantes, desafíos logísticos importantes. Hay que pensar de que Veladero es una mina que está sobre los 4.000 metros, de tal manera el que llegar con todas sus partes, especialmente con las aspas de, de esta turbina eólica tiene 40 metros de largo. El llegar por un camino cordillerano de alta dificultad, que pasa cercano a los 5.000 metros en el portezuelo de Conconta, con curvas bastante cerradas, fue una proeza importante. De tal manera que el primer punto, diría yo, es el llegar con todas las partes de esta estructura al lugar mismo donde va a ser emplazado.
Se ha tenido que evaluar no solamente la altura de los puentes, sino las características propias de los pasos fluviales. Se ha tenido que tener en cuenta hasta la misma altura de cualquier obstáculo que represente, ya sean cables, tendidos eléctricos de alta tensión, arbolado, carteles, etc.
That's a big piece of equipment to take through those roads. So we've modified the wind turbine blades so that they've got a strengthened section at 13 meters from the base. And the trailer that we'll be using will actually tilt the blade up to approximately 20 degrees when it comes to every sharp corner there.
Debido a que tenemos que hacer ascensos importantes, hay todo un desarrollo en el camino que conlleva curvas que tienen un radio de giro muy particular. Entonces, debido a la magnitud de las piezas que había que mover, no nos daba los radios de giro. Por eso se tuvieron que hacer herramientas especiales para poder adecuar el largo de estas piezas, elevándolo y tomando de esa manera un largo mucho menor para poder lograr las curvas.
Ayer en la tarde no pudimos trabajar por el viento y vamos a preparar la maniobra para subirla a la mañana, que habitualmente no hay viento, y bueno, trabajando con el pronóstico que nos brinda Barry. Cambiándole el centro de cilindro porque veníamos con un centro de gravedad a 9 metros de distancia del basculante y resulta que lo tenemos a 13 metros. Por eso vamos a correr el cilindro hacia atrás para que lo levante más fácilmente.
Ese nos va a provocar un atraso de un día y medio para todos los trabajos de modificación del sistema hidráulico.
Se hizo la prueba, se levantó el equipo. El punto más crítico es inicio de levante, lo hizo muy bien. No siguieron con el levante por el viento que tenemos.
Quite a difficult site to building anything. For a start, getting here is quite tricky.
Más arriba peor.